This is J. Arthur. Let's look at how to do a two-one-sided test, also known as an equivalence test in Excel. So here we have some data, and we're going to compare development with our quality control output. There's a quick way to do this. The QI macros are an add-in for Excel, and under statistics, once you've selected your data, you can just come down and choose equivalence tests. It'll prompt you for significance and a mean difference. And then it'll tell you the means are equivalent. So that's a quick way to get that done. Now let's look at how to do it, not in QI macros, but using the analysis toolpak. Now the first thing you have to do is install the analysis toolpak if you haven't already. Go to add-ins, Excel, options, add-ins. Go down here and hit the go button and select the analysis toolpak. Once you've done that, it'll add the data analysis toolpak. First thing we have to do is determine if the variances are the same or different. So we're going to need an F-test. And so we can select our first column here. And we can select the second column here. Tell it has labels, and I want to put that right into this sheet. And as you can see here, our p-value is greater than 0.05, so we can say that these variances are not different. I'm going to use the same space now that I know that. Clear that. And what I want to do this time is a t-test. We're going to do a t-test two different ways. So we now know we have equal variances, so we're going to use a t-test using equal variances. If not, I would have used unequal. And so again, here we're going to use column A and B, and I'm going to put that into column D. And so here you can see that our one-tail test is less than 0.05, so that's a good start. Now what we're going to do is come back and do the data analysis, but we're going to switch the columns. So we're going to use B as our first column and A as our second column. And then we're going to put that in column H. Now here you can see both of our tests are less than 0.05. What that tells us is that, yes indeed, these means are equivalent, because we can reject the null hypothesis that they are the same. So that's how you do a two-one-sided test in Excel using the QI macros. Are you still using line, bar, and pie charts from the last century? You might want to consider control charts, Pareto charts, and histograms. Smart charts for the 21st century.